Charlotte.
You can trust me. Truly.
What are you thinking?
Only that I wonder what on earth I'm to do with myself all day.
You know exactly what you're to do with yourself, Charlotte. We've gone over it again and again.
What were you doing when you were my age?
I don't know. What are you? I suppose I was still at medical school. Yes, I was. For 5 long years.
Did it disappoint you then?
No, not at all. But it was hard. Not a life you need envy, if that's what you're thinking. Still, it gave me what I wanted.
And what was it you wanted?
Something solid. Wanted to get at the reality of things. I've always wanted to know how and why. As a small boy, though, nature rather overawed me. I always thought there was some deep mystery there that I'd never unravel. You know, I remember I must have been 5 or 6 in the garden one evening with the scent of wallflowers almost overwhelming. It was a smell I'd always been very fond of, but this particular evening I was as much disturbed by it as pleased because I couldn't understand it. I didn't know what it meant.
John, if you ask questions like that, you have to turn to poetry.
Pollination's a good deal simpler than poetry. No, Mother explained pollination to me and the mystery vanished. You look tired. I've been talking too much. Come on, time for bed.
But I was so looking forward to hearing about London.
London can wait. I've been looking forward to being alone with you again in our nursery. Like another world. Wednesday evening. In the meantime, I rely on you.
I know you do, John, dear, but I'm afraid Charlotte...
Yes, I hardly want to ask you to spy on my wife, obviously.
Of course not.
For God's sake, don't worry. Lord, I must go. Yes. Goodbye, James. Goodbye, my boy.
I would not say this to a living soul, of course. course, but this is dead paper and a great relief to my mind. I do sometimes wonder if one of the reasons I don't get well faster is because John is a doctor. You see, he knows there is no reason for me to suffer. And being a practical man, that satisfies him. Still, I have my notebook. And if I do only a little work each day, I'm sure I will improve. It will relieve the press of ideas that teem in my brain. Give me rest. I believe that... I believe that to express a fear is to go halfway to overcoming it. John laughs at me, of course. But then one expects that in a marriage. I never thought of it before. But how fortunate it is that we kept this room after all. If we hadn't used it, then little James would have. Which I would not have for all the world. For there is now no doubt in my mind that there is something unwholesome here. There's Jenny. I must try to be kinder and more cheerful. She is so very careful of me. Charlotte, do sit down. Have a slice of Madeira, a biscuit, do. There's that girl again. What a comic look on her face. She's so serious, so determined. Mind you, she's making progress. She reminds me of myself at that age. I used to think when I grew up, I would publish a magazine. Dawn, I was going to call it. Or the Herald. I can never quite decide.
Don't please sit down.
But what happened when I grew up was that I met John. Doctor. It made my idea seem very trivial. I felt like some wretched little frog trying